I've grown accustomed to her face. She almost makes the day begin. I've grown accustomed to the tune she whistles night and noon. Her smiles, her frowns, her ups, her downs.
Hello.
Here comes the Catalina. Come on. I don't believe you two.
Oh, my God.
Hello.
Well, you missed the show. You should have been here. It took me exactly an hour and a half to get him in from there to here.
Hi, Patty. How are you?
He just now sat down.
Surely I could always be that way again, and yet I've grown accustomed to her looks. Accustomed to her voice.
Cute dance.
The Irish jig.
Yeah.
He came home, dance. Took a shower, and in the shower, I noticed these terrible sores on his back and chest.
What you want for Christmas?
Oh, wait a minute, I didn't see Yai over there. I skipped her.
And I called the doctor, and the doctor said it was shingles. Shingles went away after a few weeks, but it left him with what is called PHS.
Can you do a little dance for us? Hey, do a little hula. Hey. You gonna do a little hula? You gonna do a hula? Hey, baby.
PHN, which is post-herpetic neuralgia, which is a very debilitating condition. Okay, come on, big steps now. Now, the nurse comes 3 days a week. She comes in the afternoon.
She's beautiful, too.
She's beautiful. Yes, yeah, she's lovely. Her name is Monday. Monday Kalawa.
Oh, there you are.
My dear, watching you. Let's stand up. Good job.
Hold on to me.
Oh, sure. You gotta straighten your knees now. 1, 2.
Sitting at the piano and playing the piano takes a lot of physical energy and mental energy, which I don't have right now because I'm devoting that time to him. Now, that's not a good excuse, but that's the way it is. I mean, there's a limit to how much I can do in a day with him.
My father would be downstairs painting, and he got the idea that he should paint the moon that she was playing the piano about. That's where the painting, Claire de Lune, the painting is called Claire de Lune. That's where it came from, so that's why it's a special painting, because it was inspired by the music she was making.
To get a haircut. Maybe next week we'll take you over to the barber shop and get a haircut.
Did you ever pose nude for him?
No. No, I never did.
Did he ever want you to?
No, he never, no, because he had a different, he would go to art studios where there were nude models, but there was never any desire for him to paint me in the nude. There's different, again, a different dynamic between the model and the wife. That may sound strange, but that's how it was.
Let me get that back there. Right?
He created a puzzle for the viewer, as well as a mood that escapes almost imperceptibly. His work ethic stands as a model for artists of all types in that it was perpetual and steady. His marvelous creations came out of a basement with one fluorescent light, standing always so that he could move to get all views of his work. Peter allowed himself the freedom to go wherever his mind led him.
he had to get physical therapy because he lost the use of his muscles, his leg muscles especially. So this is what we're doing now. We're trying to restore him to the condition that he was in before.
You had to go for your physical, and they said you're 1A.
Mm-hmm. Stand in line, take off all your clothes, and you, you take your spoon out of your mess kit, you hold that spoon, and walk through the line, get your exam.
What's a spoon for?
Just to keep you occupied, I guess.
Everybody got their spoon out?
Everybody's got a
spoon. What a riot!
Nika's a jaybird, always spoon.
Okay, come on, let me see your legs. Come on.
Come on, let's go to Kiki.
I'm gonna do it with you, come on.
She wants a picture of me.
Hey, smile, you're on camera, baby.
What?
Smile, you're on camera.
You're on candy camera, smile.
Come on, dinner's ready. Your dinner's ready, baby.
Walk over there.
No, we're gonna go over
there.
You like the shot?
She can't be in her picture.
You don't want her to take your picture?
No.
Why?
I don't know.
You're looking good.
Unable to pursue her own education, because in a family of two boys and two girls, only the boys could go to college. Each girl worked to help the family during the boys' college years. My mom, who set aside her education and a career to take care of us. My mom, who when she did enter the workplace in search of a career, had to work so much harder and at such a pace to catch up with her peers who had been at it all along.
He was a student at Kent, of course, so he had a holiday. So he came to New York and he brought a ring with him. And he proposed to me in New York after a two months of knowledge between the two of us. So we went to a nightclub in New York City. It was a Hotel Taft. And Guy Lombardo had his band there, and we danced to Guy Lombardo's music. That was so much fun. And I just loved the Times Square scene. All the nightclubs were wonderful, the theaters, everything was so much fun. Besides taking care of him, you have grocery shopping, meal preparation, maintaining the house, maintaining the laundry, doing the grocery shopping, and all those other things which keep me very busy. And that's the life of a caregiver, and that's pretty much it.
Instead of going backwards, easier.
Hey, smile, you're on camera. Hey, you're on camera, smile.
Oh, how beautiful everything looks.
Happy Easter.
Same to you. Wait till you see it.
Oh my goodness.
For one command I stand and wait now, from one who's master of my fate now. I can't escape, for it's too late now. I'm just a prisoner of love. What's the good of my caring if someone is sharing those arms with me? Although she has another, I can't have another, for I'm not free. She's in my dreams, awake or sleeping. Upon my knees to her I'm creeping. My very life is in her keeping. I'm just a prisoner of love.
love.